I'm just clearing my heart because this is a big topic for me. I'm dropping into my heart. Heartbreaks are, I would say, one of the biggest initiations you can put yourself through and you can experience in life. Because it can be the most pain you ever experience in life is just through heartbreaks, separation, loss. They're such deep things, right? It affects everything. Every part of your being, every part of your body completely shifts your energy, heartbreaks, it can. I have experienced some pretty hard, tough heartbreaks in my life. So I'm going to be speaking from my experience, but mostly going to be speaking from more psychological experience as well. And of course, if you haven't met me, hi, I'm Susan. I'm a transformational coach and qualified therapist. So I felt like sharing this because it's one of the, I think it's something that is so hard to go through, and the more support you have, the better. And it's one of the most devastating things that I've personally been through. So I definitely want to share what I've learned from them and how I got through them. And I'll share what my worst heartbreak was. My worst heartbreak happened when I was in my gypsy phase. I was traveling around and living in just random temples, and I was living in the forest, and I fell in love with this guy, my neighbor. And it was a really toxic relationship because my anxious attachment was still, it hadn't been fully dealt with, which means my inner childhood wounds were not fully dealt with that created that attachment, that sort of attachment within me and bonding style within me. But the catalyst of that was that it propelled me into therapy. It propelled me into learning how to connect to my inner child. So what helped me, I mean, honestly, I didn't really heal from that heartbreak for a long time. It was probably took me over a year, and it got worse. So my codependency came out when I got into another relationship, like when I was still healing and I was still so heartbroken, and I got into another relationship, but it wasn't a serious one. It was very much an anxious / avoidant dynamic, which is a push and pull intensity, intense chemistry, but our needs aren't, like, my needs were not being met, and I wasn't really honoring, I wasn't really honoring myself, and just an emotional mess because I was still healing from these layers of heartbreak. And how does it feel to be heartbroken? It's really hard to be present. Every time pain comes up, it does the tendency to just run and disconnect from it. There's sensitivity around everything because everything kind of hurts. So there's a sensitivity, and because everything kind of hurts, it's not that fun to be around people. And it's not even that fun to be, like, everything just feels a bit heavy and painful, and there's this stuck feeling, like, when is this pain going to end? And then, but then there's this feeling, the silver lining is that there's this underlying strength and power that comes through, which is, okay, this is my opportunity to heal something really deep. Because the reason why there's so much pain in heartbreak is that it can bring up our core wounds. If your core wound is betrayal, it can bring up betrayal. If you're caught, and that is usually connected to your childhood. So what happened in your childhood that was the most painful that you hadn't fully resolved and looked into and processed, that's connected to, usually that's what can be triggered in a separation, in a heartbreak, because this core wound from your childhood finally comes up, and for me it was abandonment. But for another person, it might be betrayal. For another person, it might be rejection. For another person, it could be feeling completely worthless or unsafe in the world. So the silver lining is with every heartbreak, there is opportunity to heal something deeper. There's an opportunity to heal and meet your inner child and your most vulnerable self in areas that maybe you have never met before, that only you can do that, and your partner can't do it for you. You got to do it for you. Your exes can't do it for you. And so it's a big process of integration. It can feel like shadow work because all the parts that you don't want to look at, it can start to come out. But yeah, heartbreak, like the key to recover from heartbreak is to choose love. And I know that sounds like the biggest paradox, but I don't mean avoidant love. I don't mean love as in I'm just gonna get a rebound. I mean really choose true love, like choose to keep your heart open. Choose to This is what helped me. The last separation I had was the best one I've had in my life. But these are things that I did differently. I chose love relentlessly. I came back to love. I did whatever work I could do to come back to love. And for me, that was literally like lying on this wooden structure where it would open up my chest. Like it really, I had to lie on the floor and my chest would open. And the intention was to keep my heart open and to release anything that is not of love, and to forgive and to release and to process what's alive. So I just, instead of running away, closing my heart and shutting off from the world, I did the opposite this time. I was like, world, I am here. I want to feel everything. I'm willing to let it go. Doesn't matter how painful it is. I want to feel what the root behind all this is. It was just this massive, expansive process. I was also doing breath work at least twice a week. That would help me release, release, release. It's all about keeping the energy moving and being willing to meet yourself with more love. I did inner child work, so checking in with my inner child, being like, okay, knowing what core wound was activated and bringing her all the love that she would have needed when she had that core wound activated in her when she was a child. Imagine a little girl or a little boy feeling what you felt, like feeling the heartbreak that you're feeling as an adult. Imagine processing that in that tiny body. How scary. No wonder kids that have been traumatized dissociate, and no wonder they, end up getting in these unhealthy relationships when they are an adult. It's a lot, it's very deep, it's very painful. But it takes courage to come back to love, to choose to keep the heart open, to breathe, and to breathe, to move it through. Of course, allow yourself to be supported through with a therapist that you really trust. Allow yourself to be heard. Allow this therapist to support you in supporting yourself and your inner child. And prayer. I prayed so much and I had people pray for me. And every time it gave me like a bit of an escape from, not escape, but it really soothed my emotions. Even if it was just for 30 minutes, or even if it was just for, 10 minutes, it was something. And those small moments of receiving helped me move forward and be willing to open and come back to love more and more. So it's a bit of a training of the heart for love, because heartbreaks can either open up your heart more and help you grow, or you can do the opposite. And if you don't deal with it in a way that is helpful, it can do the opposite, which is you can close your heart and you can close yourself off from experiencing a better love in the future. So be a love warrior and choose to open up your heart to yourself and to God and to source and to the world and to nature and to the things that, just open up your heart and keep it open. And I really do suggest working with your inner child, reparenting your inner child as best as you can during this time. Use this time to propel you into a deep journey of healing, of unraveling anything from your past that is being triggered, and to bring love to that part of you. Allow yourself to be supported. Allow yourself to be prayed for. Allow your friends to hold you. It's so easy to shut ourselves off and shut down our hearts during separation, but if you can let yourself be vulnerable and let yourself be held, give yourself that grace, you deserve it. You didn't have to go through it alone. Another thing is, with the courage of being willing to transform this pain into a gain, and to transform this painful experience into a positive one, is to really go within and to allow the love that's available out there, whether it's through God, through Jesus, through nature, through the sun or the moon. Just allow that higher energy to enter you through meditation and meditative practices. I was meditating, the last separation, I was meditating around 2 to 3 hours a day, and it really transformed my experience. It helped me move on and helps me move forward so much quicker in an empowered way. And it broke me through, because there were moments after, you know, after my first hour of meditating, I would literally feel like I was being held by so much light. And I literally felt like the pain was no longer there. There was just a serene peace. And to experience those moments of serene peace during separation is, oh, wow, it's miraculous. The universe, I felt like God, Source was working miracles on me, that I felt like I was opening my heart up and my whole body up to being really held. So I am sending everyone so much love who is going through a hard separation. If it's just happened, I feel you. I know what it's like. There's definitely so many ways for you to love, to keep choosing love, because there is always better and higher love out there if you allow yourself to open up, and if you allow yourself to choose to come back to love. A lot of the times people may get into a toxic relationship that comes with really heavy and intense heartbreaks, is because that relationship was based on fear from the get-go. It was based on fear. And when you make one decision out of fear, it creates a ripple effect of more fear. And that's why there's this intensity, because underlying it, it's just a scared child that just wants love. There's a scared child that just wants to be validated. There's a scared child that just wants to be held. And that child is needy. It's needy. It's needy because it needs something. It's needing its needs to be met, which was not met when it was a child. Your 8-year-old self, your 12-year-old self, your 9-year-old self may be needing this love from that, or need that love from that toxic partner, because it didn't get it from its parents. You didn't get it from your parents. And I'm sorry if you went through that. And you're not alone. You're not alone. Actually, most of the clients I work with, they had unmet needs as a child. And when they learn how to reparent the inner child and give themselves that love and open themselves up to greater love that they could, that they didn't even know could exist, it's miraculous. You think you've experienced love? Maybe you haven't, honey. Maybe there is actually greater love out there waiting for you. Maybe there's actually a greater, higher love out there that you have never experienced. And when you do experience it, it's going to change your life, change who you are. It's going to be healing and completely shifting for you. So for me, it was like God was a big part of that. Jesus, the love of Jesus is so incredible. And I've experienced the love of Mary Magdalene. I've experienced the love of Isis. I've experienced the love of Goddess Lakshmi. I've experienced the love of nature. Nature's pretty awesome too. But the love of God was like, whoa, next level. honoring you. I see you. You're going to get through this. If you are going through it, you are going to get through this. I know the pain. And if you need any extra support, I'm here for you. I am a qualified therapist. So please reach out if you need any extra support. Okay. Much love.